The endosymbiotic theory deals with the concept of life beginning as a prokaryotic organism and then progressing to eukaryotic organisms. In the beginning, the original cells were prokaryotic and began to increase in size. As the cells increased, they became more complex and needed more genetic material to be able to regulate all they did. There are theories about where the genetic material came from, such as from viruses or the environment. As the cells became larger, they needed more membrane in order to function. These membranes would have come from an invagination of the cellular membrane. Eventually, there was a rather complex network of membranes on the inside of the cells. Also, it is theorized that at some point a bacterium became engulfed and remained inside the cell, becoming what is known as the mitochondrion. With plants, it is theorized that a cyanobacterium was engulfed in the same way and became the chloroplast. The concept is supported by the following. Both mitochondria and chloroplasts have a singular chromosome and 70S ribosomes. The genetic material of the mitochondrion is independent of the nuclear genome. The nuclear membrane is doubled, as is the membrane around the mitochondrion and chloroplast. Currently, the endosymbiotic theory is an excellent explanation for the structure of the eukaryotic cell, and given time, this theory could be substantiated based on genetic sequencing of the mitochondrial DNA.